Hello. So, some might be thinking, well, I'm not seeing so many ABC denials anymore, so we must be getting close. And nothing could be more farther from the truth. Because if you think about it, actually what we're achieved so far is basically just logging in. We're not doing anything yet. And besides that, we're running in permissive mode, and not everything gets logged the first time around. And even then, there are some things that are hidden. Oh, wrong password again. By default. That we also need to take care of. So there's actually a lot to be done yet. So we're having a time of 15:30, so I'll make that 15:29. Let's see what we have. Still a lot of stuff to take care of. Well, actually it's not that much, but we have here. Your minor FS doing some stuff. So let's just grab TR minor FS. See what it's actually doing. It's basically mining stuff. TR minor FS. That's why it's called minor. So this thing actually. It doesn't actually read the files. It reads directories and it gets attributes of files. So we need to basically allow that. Out it to allow. That user home. That those are the default there. It wants to list the user home there. So we all need to allow this stuff. So let's do that. TR minor FS. Oh, my comment there below, all the way below. Miner is mining. And then I don't have to basically include anything. Okay, let's go back and see what else we have. So we have various things. Reading temp t dirs. So let's see what dirs we're talking about. Grab temp t less. Is that the actual temp there, or is that some mislabeled dir? So yeah, temp is actually mounted. So they're actually, that's temp fast, so they're actually reading these dirs, listing them. So basically we can allow these as well. Out it to allow. And then but yeah, well, we'll just allow them first. So this is data dub mom, but it needs more than just this. manager applet. And an apple. Don't ask me why it's doing this, what business it has. Because I don't know. And TPMC. TPMC. Because I don't know. What else do we have? And we have a bunch of user domain stuff. Let's see what stuff DCL is trying to execute. I knew it was was also mmapping, or actually, yeah, or mmapping or testing for exec. Events, grep, gshell, and now it's actually, oh, that's still events. Oh, I didn't restore from events, or maybe restore from v user bin events. Yeah. That should get rid of that. Alright, so what I'm going to do now, and now it's getting really nasty, I think, is I'm going to unload hidden denials. Show everything that's hidden. Oh, right, I didn't save. Need to save first. And that'll show a lot more ABC denials. ABC denials that upstream things that aren't, that we shouldn't need. Let's log out. And let's see what these are. First, let's kill and clear and get rid of the temp stuff, and then just also 1537. So here we already have some grab XDM, grab execute actually. Audit to allow grab execute. See what we get here. damage, you basically a pen tattoo. My XDM TE. The stuff that's probably required. Let's go back. Less that because there's much more. So we have all these things want to append. So first let's just add these. Up nicely. So we have default context search. I search it there. So yeah, that makes sense. Let's just get that in the right place. And I'm probably once more after that as well. Security file, once we read security file, do we have something security already? Yeah? And we'll just append that for read open. And we have a Netlix as a Linux socket. Do we have it? Yeah, and that needs to read. See, because what they did was basically make assumptions. Read. No, that might do it. Not sure. So the appends for now I'll skip the session. Do we have any cells? Yep, we do. And let's basically, I'll just paste it in here for a second. Right. what else do we have? Fixes. These for now, I'll just ignore. That's it for now. Let's build. Make and build. And we have a unknown type. Oh right. Nano my XDM TE. Require type things. Like T, and this is not right. Load that. And then wait a minute, and then try it again. I'm going to test a couple of times. And then work that a couple of times. minutes. So we're waiting for 15 45, or a little bit later. So you think you're close, and of course we're getting a little bit close to something, but there's always issues, either don't audit, or like audit is basically not showing everything every time. So we're at 45 now. We can just try this out, see where it goes. So we have this XDM stuff that I'm going to allow. Then we have this whole bunch of stuff. Here we have new things that we need to go through. Oh, actually didn't save it, did I? I might just not have saved it. Let's see if I have. Read open, security file read open, soft write, config, T has a link. Shell exec. But I just forgot to save. Stupid me. And here we have David Dupmon doing some stuff. Self. And what is that? Is it not the ground software, so we drive. Okay. Then we have DNSSEC doing a read-write on a TCP socket, and that's also expected since it's actually connecting to DNSSEC ports. Of course, I'll also need to require that. Okay, we have Netlink route socket for Evolution Address Factory. Evo address. Netlink route socket. And there was. Let's copy it just to be sure. Read right. So these get hidden because someone assumes that those are leaked file descriptors. And that's just a shitty thing to do, because if you're writing policy, then it just doesn't show up. And you think, oh, I'm done. Yeah, right. Evo alarm search on my door. And that's right. See, so we find bugs. This was read, and this is a search actually. It's not reading, it's just traversing. So that was. This was that. Now we're at Evo Calendar Factory. Evo Calf. And the same thing. It's our read write. I'll need to actually, I don't need to require that here. Read write. That's a duplicate requirement. Then we have fuse mount. Fuse mount. And that's basically what it's doing. It's added here. Debug FS. So we need to require debug FS. Need debus. And let's just allow a get attribute here as well. And then it's actually a read write here. With, and this might actually be a leak. So I'll make a comment. I'll disallow it right now because I want to basically get rid of it as much as possible. But it looks like a leak, smells like a leak, looks like a leak. We have here a FIFO file inheritance. GKRD. You know what? I'm just going to go all up because I know it's the first one. Don't want to. So I'll just add that here. Though it doesn't quite belong there. FIFO file. Online accounts name wants to write datagram socket. GOID. Write datagram socket. GOID self datagram socket. Right. And then we have a lot of other things. G session execute. Probably don't audit it that. And we have this looks like it's not actually testing. It might actually be mmapping, so let's just shell. All the way below, let's see where we have this stuff. So here we have this test, and let's just allow it to get attributes. It's probably mmapping it, I think. And let's see what we have, and I'll paste this stuff in above here. Let's see. So it's still executing a binary, of trying to execute a binary. This can be removed. RPM var lib g, do we have something RPM var lib g? Yep. And that's a get attribute, isn't it? And it's a foul. Is that a foul? No. So foul get attribute. And then we have the netlink route socket dance. Netlink route socket self. Where are you? Self netlink route socket read write. It's reading the routing table. And now this bin file, I need to see where that's what that's about. What do we else do we have? Read append, read append. Pulse audio. Socket file, right, datagram socket, right, pulse audio, oh damn. Datagram socket, right. Pulse audio, where are you? Right there. And then this is, we can ignore this stuff for now. This is basically the user domain. That seems to be it. So let's grep for bin t. Shell, g shell, grep g shell, and then grep for bin t. See what's execute, actually. See what it's trying to execute right now. Eye of Gnome. And we need to confine that as well, or at least give it a private type as well. Where's Eye of Gnome? Where is EOG? And EOG is in user bin EOG, so let's take care of that. Save this. User bin, EOD, and then EOD exact D. Go back to the type enforcement file and go all the way below. And do the similar to what we did for events. EOD. And basically for later, just say starting point so that EOD. Let's see if this builds. So probably not. Unknown class, netlink route socket. That's a silly thing. So, netlink route socket. I would have sworn I'd have required it somewhere. Oops. Basis for now. I guess not. So I'm go all the way up or as far as I can. Basically search for the first netlink route socket and then just require it there. Building. And then basically restore con user bin. Oh, and I forgot to add that. Well, doesn't matter because we're not there by a long shot anyways. Restore con user v user bin EOD. Log off. Now just go through this again. See if we can find stuff that we didn't see before. Bands, this is line current policy, but this isn't. So let's check this, these two out. Let's see what we have. So this is what we were asked. Security file, read, open. So this we have. Unix datagram sockets, right. So this was what we didn't have. What else? So shell exec. This was don't audit it. Yeah, this was don't audit it. Okay. Then we have datagram socket for Kirin Daemon. Oh, actually, I'm just going to go up datagram socket self. No datagram sockets here. Oh, here. Right. I should just move this above. Right. So that's that. This is allowed. And G session, the execute is probably taken care of. This is old. Events. Events exactly. I thought we dealt with that. Let's see. Gnome shell. It's all the way below. I would have sworn that I dealt with that. Let's look it up. Events. Actually, don't audit it. We need to allow that. That's allowed in the current policy. This needs to be allowed. Login sessions, tdir search. Login sessions to search. And there is our attempt. This is allowed, the current policy. This isn't allowed. Then we have this stuff that we need to basically take off later. And here we have some stuff. Execute Binti for, so we need to grab this. See what it executes. And we have a block suspend, but this is not our business. And we have XDM executing, or actually, I don't know. So, grab XDM, grab execute, add it to allow, and just take that to my XDM. And then let's see, grab this mother, grab execute, see what this is executing. All right, that's right. We should just allow that. So this is XRDB. XRDB, and then basically allow it to execute and execute no trunks. But just basically start first. Oh, right, this is don't audit it. This is don't audit it, so that's fine. see if we have user agency denials, and also see if there's stuff in var log. We need to clean this up as nice as possible. So user agency. We actually do audit to allow. So we have fingerprint. So shell. Now fingerprint. Talking to the fingerprinter, and then this required a type. I'll just use it, do it on this new type. But there's more. Realm. Didn't even know I had a realm D, but I guess I do. Oh, this is so messy. What the hell am I doing? Okay. Let's also check out some tail dot. Till end. Now let's have 500 var log messages, and then just basically pipe that to either to allow and see if this if it catches everything. Wow! Holy moly! We're far from done. There's a lot of chatting going on. Applet. NM Apple. NM Apple. Okay, so it's. Let's do this a little bit here. So we have it sending a message and acquiring, and that's fine. Acquiring service. We have Etsy doing a whole lot of stuff here. And it's at speed 2 though. At speed 2. Well, debussing. So it's basically acquiring service on the. On the session bus. Chatting to the JavaScript console. Actually, now I'm doing something wrong. Again, keep doing that. Doing that, that's so stupid. That's so stupid. Now I'm about to do it again. And then this one. A lot of divas chatting. At speed, also requiring service. And it's chatting to session. So you can basically make a lot of stuff conditional by just denying access to chat to another. Then it's probably end of story. Canberra. Where are you divas chatting? Nowhere. But now you are. Let's have a look. Weird, Canberra was sending a message but not receiving it. Okay, so just allow this. It's a bit confusing, to be honest. And this is actually one way. GVFSD. Might be some duplicates in these rules. Deconf. Oh no. Yeah, no, this is not this shit. It's gonna take ages to find that. But I'm going to go through that step by step. Deconf, where are you? There you are. So let's see the chatting below. A lot of chatting going on there. This is actually two-way. And this is one way. Damn. Yeah, these boys are chatty. You think you're done, and actually you're just only just beginning. A lot of work. So usually when they send a message, they get a message back. They are dip mode. Yeah, we can basically go through all those as well. They are dip mode. But need a sip of my coffee first. Same for this. So this is just the cleanup phase, for at least for the start. Basically, what we're working towards now is basically getting this stuff to boot. Where everything is, where the defaults are confined. Once we have that, then we have a base, and then we can basically do the fun stuff. But you need a solid base first, and that's the tough part. Then we have DNSSEC. DNSSEC, mom. They're all chatting. One big happy family, so to speak. Well, God knows what business it has with GVSD. Very well. Actually, this doesn't make sense, this one. this for now. And do I have... Yeah, I'm having other stuff as well. Canberra did the same. Canberra. All right, I did the single one. That's fine. That's good. I wasn't sleeping. Okay. This one. Evo address. Factory Evo add so this is a single, these are going two way. Damn it, work. Same here, two ways. Two ways. And then Evo alarm. Evo alarm. This is one way, this is two ways. There might be some duplicate Divas rules. I hope not, but could be. And duplicates, yeah, it's not nice, but it's not that bad either. This is so mind-killing. You really need to stay sharp when you do this stuff, because this is basically what does a lot of the access stuff. Some session bars, and then we have this one checking to the service registry or something like that. So Evo a source registry. Evo there we are. So let's remove the stuff that we don't need. This is already done. This is already done. This is already done. Then we have these left, so let's check Broadcom search provider. Oh, wait a minute. I'm just going to allow him. Because my mind is blowing up. And the stupid thing is, these messages should just go to user ABC, but instead they go to Varlog messages. So always, when you do this stuff, always keep an eye on Varlog messages, because some ABC denials actually go there. Used to that, so that's why. No boxes. D box. Search provider. And it's getting service on the session bus, and then it's actually getting to G-shell. Sip of my coffee. Coffee actually gets more tastier when it's when it's older. So when it's a little bit cold, more aroma. Okay. Keep going. Network manager applet. Let's see if we have network manager applet. We already did that, didn't we? No, we didn't. Dconf D2. Search provider. Keep on search provider. Gcom from one perspective, it's nice that it's all going via Dbus. it really makes things lots easier if you can basically, instead of doing something yourself, basically message the other party and say, hey, can you do that for me or something like that. Or whatever. Or chatting via sockets all the time is also very ugly because you have to label all the sockets. And this is cleaner. This is the JavaScript console. And I bet this one is loud. About it. So I'm just happy that that orbit stuff is gone. That saves a lot of problems. We used to have this gconfdir in temp and it was full of sockets. That was a mess back in the GNOME 2 days. Keyring daemon. TPMC, we did have. Did we do TPMC already? No. Oh, actually, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go up. So it's acquiring servers, so I could just basically make it a little simpler. Acquire servers. Chatting to mission control, telepathy. TOAD. It's actually chatting to itself. Gee. Via D-Bus. Can't you just use a FIFO file or something? So Evo is, are these Evos chatting? Yeah. stuff's gonna go. A J console can also go, and then the remainder stays TOAD. TOAD. So these can go, and then these the first time I see a service chatting to itself here, I do this. Might be some other program running in the same domain though, so it might not actually be the same internal. Probably not. ETSP check Excel. ETSP to check Excel. Session check Excel. G session check Excel. This is one way. Then we have G session. Yep. And also damn. Let's just do that by the other debug stuff. Is there must be some other debug stuff, isn't there? ETSP2 was doing that, wasn't it? ETSP2 session and ETSP also. So we can basically get rid of these two. And deconf was doing that. Yeah, deconf was doing that as well. Yep. And GVSD, we didn't have that yet. Data converts. checking anywhere. Another knight you can see. But if he was chatting to the user. These settings, diamond. Also internal. Oh man, what a work, what a huge task. This really needs to get cleaned up. So this one can be appended. I'll just do that. Send message. Remove that one. Deconf. Is deconf. Chatting to GZD, yep. So we can remove that. G-shell, did we already do G-shell? No, we didn't do G-shell yet. GSD stuff. So we'll take the remainder. Again, there may be duplicates. Clean it up later. Maybe someone else can help me clean that up. Clean something up. That would be nice if there was would be some teamwork. Well, maybe one day. Might be an interesting project for others, this can be useful. GZD, and now here we have G-shell. Most of this stuff could probably just be so, the Gbox search provider. Where are you? No, I did you. Yeah. Was chatting to GNOME Shell. So we can basically get that out of the way. The contact search provider. Did we already have that one? Yeah, we also did that one, and it's also already chatting too. Oops. The JavaScript console, also already done. GZD was also Yeah. And then network manager applet, did you do that already? So these stuffs need to be done. Alrighty, that's the shell. Evo search registry. We already did that. See it. Evo search registry. I thought we already had that. Oh yeah, we did. And it's also already shell, so we only need Christ. We only need the first one. G shell Caldi. G shell D. And we can extend this. This is getting service on the bus. And then GGSD. AFC for monitor. AFC for mon. A lot of the stuff is already checked into it. So this acquired service, we can extend that. Day of the month, we got that. Did we shell now DR minor FS? G shell. Yeah. this one is done. But now it's, I don't think so. Let's just, because the longer I look at that list, I'm starting to get dizzy. Ouch, is that Uber stuff? AC for mom. Fuzzy. TVFSD Fuzzy. Any deeper stuff here? No. Nothing. This one is one way, but this one is two ways. Volume monitor, T-photo volume monitor, T-photo volume on. He said. So we have an acquired service and sent messages. Sent. That's it. Day of the month, these two are set. Do we have no shell? Probably also. Let's just look. No shell. Yep. And then these two are remaining. GCSD, long list. Very chatty indeed. Where is it? Yeah, probably better to just GCSD. Man. Canberra. Okay, I'm trying to do my best. Canberra. Did we chat to GCSD? Yeah, we did. So we can remove Canberra. Abort applet. Did we chat to GCSD? Yeah, we did. So we can remove it. Day of Dirtmon, David Chat. Yeah, we did. DNS Setmon. Yeah, we did. evil alarm. Yeah, we did. Evil source registry. Yeah, we did. Contact search provider. JavaScript console. Yeah, we did. Online accounts. Yeah, we did. Session. Yeah, we did. Settings daemon. Yeah, we did. Shell. Yep, we did. Fuse. Yeah, we did. AFC mom. AFC mom, we didn't. And photo for mom, we didn't either. So let's just do this. Busy right now. Thought I was done. Well, no ways. This just goes on and on and on. So let's just take a little break right now. A small break.